What's going on, guys? Welcome to another video. I have something special for you guys today. Well, I don't know if you would call it special. I have some deadlift footage for you guys today. What's going on, guys? Welcome to another day in the vlog. It is about 2 o'clock in the afternoon right now. I literally spent 2 hours watching YouTube in bed. As you guys know, I usually wake up around like 12 o'clock in the afternoon because of my overnight job. So that's basically what I've been doing for the past 2 hours. So we're actually gonna head to Starbucks right now to get our pre-workout meal. I got like a breakfast sandwich and those egg white bite things, and obviously my iced tea. And then we're gonna head to actually East End to go bench today because I need a lift off, because I told myself that I'm going to be needing a lift off during my peaking block. So that's what is on the agenda for today. So what do y'all think about what happened at Astroworld and with Travis Scott that happened like recently, like that whole situation? Like, in my opinion, I'm still going to be, you know, playing Travis Scott's music because he's one of my, like, you know, favorite artists. Going into it, I was more like leaning towards like Travis Scott should have done this to kind of like make the situation better, or he could have done that. But at the end of the day, the more that I like watch all these videos on the matter and everything with social media, I'm kind of leaning towards that it's not really Travis Scott's fault. It's about the people that were running the event. I don't know what the company's name, but I heard a whole bunch of things, and like the source that I heard it from, they're kind of a reputable source. So you know what, at the end of the day, if an event happens, it all comes down with the people that hold the event and that is responsible for the event, like their staffing and stuff like that. Because obviously Travis Scott didn't hire everyone to work the event. He worked with a company. He was just an artist there. He was the headliner. He's not in charge of all the people working there. I believe that Travis Scott shouldn't be blamed so much. Like, the people holding the event should be blamed more. But anyway, I'm not gonna ramble on about the situation. I'm still going to, you know, play Travis Scott's music. So Thank you for tuning into my TED Talk. Let's get this Starbucks because I'm really hungry. Guys, I've tried to make this same clip about 10 times right now, and I can't successfully do it for some weird reason. But I'm going to try to do it successfully on this try, so hope you guys like the workout footage that you guys just saw. It was really busy in the gym, and I didn't get a chance to like get all the angles that I've wanted. But anyway, as you guys know, I end off a lot of my push workouts with the same thing. We're going to end off the video with another topic that has been lingering inside my head and I want to share with you guys. I got this topic from an Instagram reel that my friend did. Shout out to Alexus Sudam. I'm going to put her socials in the description and also on the screen right now. She's just doing her thing and I want to show love because this reel that she posted was the topic that has been lingering inside my head, so here it is.
You want to know why strangers support you more than people you know? Because people you know have a tough time accepting the fact that you came from the same place while they are still in the same place. Now let that sink in.
So, before I ramble on, the point that I'm trying to make about this is that just show your friends and family and people that you don't know doing the same thing that you do or on their journey, no matter what it is, show them some love and support because you never know how that is going to impact them. At the end of the day, we're all trying to win. We're all trying to eat at the same table. And honestly, there's so much food in the world to feed everyone. So spread that love, spread that support, guys. Like, that's all I'm trying to say. Because obviously the Instagram reel is pretty self-explanatory. It's super important to just basically support. Just support everyone that you know. Because again, like I said, you never know how that is going to impact their mind on their journey. Like for example, in my opinion, I've always thought that I was being judged doing YouTube. Because like, why are you doing this for? Like you're spending so much time, effort, and money into something that you don't know that is going to be successful, or it's going to be hard to be successful because it's so saturated. Whenever I go into the gym, I know for a fact that I'm being judged because, again, I come into the gym with my camera, and it's not like a rinky-dink camera. It's a mirrorless camera. It's a DSLR, and it's pretty noticeable that I have a camera. Obviously with my microphone too, but anyway, I also come with my tripod, so it kind of like discourages me to kind of bring my camera into the gym. But at the same time, I think about it myself, like, this is what I love to do and this is what I'm gonna do. If people hate, they hate. If people show love, they show love. Like, I mean, obviously people should show love everywhere you go because you know for a fact they're grinding at whatever they're doing. Like, especially in the gym, like, you should always congratulate people if they go for a PR, or if you see a change in their body, you should always tell them like, hey, yo, you're doing really well, like, I hope things are going good. If people show more love and support in the world, like, the world will be more positive. But anyway, so like,
a couple days ago, it was really busy in the gym. I had my camera and I was like putting my camera in different spots, trying to get different angles for you to like for you guys to enjoy or see the workout. Multiple groups of people were just staring at me, and I know they were talking smack. They were talking something about me with my camera. Like, do I know for a fact they were doing this? No, but why would you stare at me and talk to your friends? Like, one person I think was pointing at me, which, like, dude, can you be any more subtle? That discourages me because like I'm just doing my thing, man. I'm not bothering anybody. My camera's not in anybody's way. Just don't talk smack about somebody, you know? Like, a good thing is that this one guy, I don't know why these other guys don't be like this one guy, but anyway, this one guy approached me and he asked me about, like, do I make YouTube videos and stuff like that, and I'm like, yeah, and then we exchanged socials, and he supports my YouTube videos now, and you know, we're pretty cool in the gym now. So, again, the point that I'm trying to make, guys, is just show love and support to everyone that you know, and help them win, because without support and love, the motivation that we have to keep going, it will be affected. Maybe it will affect some of us more than others. I'm not going to lie to you. I was in that position that I talk smack about people doing what I do, and they're doing 10 times better. But I've learned, and I'm still working on it now. I'm not going to sit here and say like I don't do this at all. I'm still working on it now, but now that I learned that all these people are doing is trying to win, trying to be successful. So I'm just going to add to their success by supporting them and showing love. I hope you guys like the video. We're about, I believe, 4 weeks out from competition, and things are going pretty well. My body is feeling well. So yeah, you guys will see more videos on the progress, but yeah. Stay positive, stay motivated. Again, go support my girl, Alexus Sudam. Her socials are going to be in the description. So yeah, I hope you guys liked the video. See you guys in the next one. Peace.